Holy crap, there is more to the 7th year anniversary, and today we're going to look at what is possibly to come in part 4. They're doing a part 4 for Dokkan anniversary. This is actually super crazy. So first off, if you log into the game right now, they have a special video for you to play on your first login. I've already watched this and it was beautiful. If this was played at like the last day of Dokkan, I'd be like, man, I'm satisfied. What a journey. Seventh anniversary Dokkan battle. And then a little hint of what's to come. The final Vegeta and Goku rival moment. All right, so then we get the news, which pretty much Minato just says they confirm EX 7th anniversary. EX, I think, just means extra. It's not like some new mechanic. And there'll be new story events and new extreme battles, which if we jump into the game as well, because I'd like to show you guys instead of screenshots. First off, in your gift box, you're getting a free 30 Dragon Stones, wallpapers, stuff like that, which is dope. So I'm going to go and accept that. And then, in the news section, got a few new tabs here. Right, this is for the 30 Dragon Stones, but this is what I'm talking about, baby! We are getting a new free-to-play Ella that looks to be a GT Heroes leader that's guaranteed to be over a 100% leader. That's awesome, GT Heroes. Another GT, but it's not Shadow Dragon Saga, unfortunately, but I'll take the GT Heroes buff for sure. They're an AGL unit, so a nice AGL buff as well. That's the worst free-to-play, like, typing. So just in that self is already good. I wonder how crazy they're going to be. And then there's, like I said, potential of more EZAs and story events. This could be another Dokkan Fest EZA. There's so many like opportunities everywhere because this, you know, it's a Goku and Vegeta revival kind of thing. So, you know, like Gogetas, Gokus, any Vegeta, honestly. Now, as I'm recording this, we should get more information in a few hours. So I won't post this video like as soon as possible. I'll probably wait. While we're waiting though, a little catch up on global. I know, I can't forget about global. In 17 hours, we have the EZA free-to-play cards coming out. I'll be live stream farming them. So make sure you check me out, twitch.tv/JPhanta. Trunks and Half-Virus Goku's coming to the game, which is obviously a skip. And then we have the EZA Zamasu. We have the EZA Tech Trunks, which is, those two are fairly decent. We have the EZA for Android 13 as well as 14-15. And then on the 9th of March, finally, we'll be having the LR Prime Battle Trunks, which is a pretty decent card as well. So free-to-play is getting a lot of love in this celebration, obviously. And then pay to play, you just get another session where you don't need to spend any Dragon Stones, essentially, which is amazing. Now, Zunes, I do have 50 Dragon Stones. I'm still chasing some Redstone cards, so I might as well jump into the Kaioken Goku and Vegeta banner. Looking for the featured Redstone units, baby. Give me a god animation, please. Damn. God animation, you could get like 3 redstone units. Give me multiple. Multiple? My MHA luck is really bad, so, you know, can you... At least, there's got to be luck somewhere digging down here. Alright, well, that's not great. That is not a good multi at all. Alright, so it's now news time for Dokkan, just a few hours later. And it looks as though the next Dokkan Fest unit is going to be a Captain Ginyu. I'd assume it's just Captain Ginyu by himself. Maybe he turns into Captain Ginyu Goku. That would be super awesome. This card might be the thing that the EZA Ginyu Force just needs. Next up, we finally have the EZA for the Bardock Squad. Let's go. Looks like they're running them in batches as well, so you only get like two per, like they did with the Guinea Force, like two per like week or something like that. And then Bardock will be last, and then we'll probably get the final copies of Ella Bardock once you finally EZA them all, which is crazy. I would like to also mention that on the EZA image there, it says six characters. So that means there's a high chance that the Ella will also EZA, making a dub over the Ginyu Force. We got the 48th Ultimate Clash. And then within the Ultimate Clash, you can finally EZA the Ella physical Ginyu Force. So it's like, that is great. Free to play is eating so good. What the heck? Oh my God. This is so dope, dude. I don't know where you're going to get these medals. I can't read the kanji here, but I'd assume you just purchased them through the shop. That's what I would assume. And then with all of that, we'll include a new Super Battle Road stage, stage 56, which I believe is the Kamehameha category. This might be a really hard category because you know how buff that category is. So this will be interesting. It will either be really easy or just really hard because the bosses will just scale along with all like these strong ass Kamehameha category units. And then for the remaining news for the EX 7-year anniversary, we have the EZAs for Ella Super Saiyan 4 Goku and Ella Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, which is absolutely insane right now. Actually crazy. I wouldn't have thought that these guys would EZA this anniversary. We just got in the 3-year. So I was like, maybe a few more months until the Super Saiyan 4s, you know, start to EZA. But to think that they're doing it now is actually crazy. Might accelerate that the 5th year anniversaries will EZA next year as well. So now I'm just going to wait until the full details have been translated, of course, so that we can see what they're up to. So Koresh with the speedy translations right here. So shout outs to him. Goku's family 180% leader skill is actually insane for how crazy that category is already. You know, super AGL, key plus 3, 130% stat boost. Attack and defense plus 140% and attack plus 20% at the start of every turn up to 60%. Gain an additional 2 key per rainbow or AGL key sphere obtained. Gain an additional 1 key per type key sphere obtained other than STR. Medium chance to evade enemy's attack counter with tremendous power. Nullifies targeted enemy's action once when launching active skill or when super attack is launched when key is 24 or more. So, when his key is 24. Now, so it's going to be like the LR, which is crazy good already. So that's one action stun, which is super clutch. Already crazy, as well as the 25 key multiplier, you know, the high stats with the attack and defense. 12 keys, massively raise defense and raise attack for one turn, deals colossal. 18 key, massively raises attack and defense for one turn, causes mega colossal and greatly lowers defense. Awesome stuff, awesome stuff. Dev, I would probably run now the LR Super Saiyan 4 Goku as the Goku's family leader for free to play. I think it's safe to say that. And then Vegeta's family is the same deal here, but instead for his passive attack defense plus 140% and attack and defense plus 20% at the start of every turn, max of 30% attack and defense plus 60%. So more on the defensive side. Then gain an additional 2 key rainbow, blah, blah, blah. He gets a lot of key, medium chance, counters. Pretty much everything's the same other than like the first part there. Now he does not massively raise defense. Instead, just raise defense. I think Goku's still more defensively good just because, only if they 12 key. I think Vegeta's like defensively better if like it's only the 12 key and you don't get any additional super attacks because they still massively raise attack and defense. So it's only when the 12 key happens when Goku's like a lot more better defensively, I think. But yeah, another nice Vegeta's family buff as well. So that is, again, super crazy. I think that's going to wrap it up for today's news video. Super hype day for Dokkan Battle. I can't wait to start grinding these free-to-play units. Remember, I'll be live at twitch.tv/JPhanta when any of these free-to-play cards drop. So make sure you follow me, link in the description. I'll see you guys in the next one. Until then, stay healthy, stay safe, stay fizzy. Peace out.